Where are you?
Okay.
Where are you?
Let's.
Camp, you want fire?
Okay. Left trigger. Campfire.
No, this might be a short session.
Greetings, adventurers. Don here with a session of Don't Starve Together. And I am here together with my friend. Introduce yourself.
I am the very cute GM, as always, and I am running around circles around you right now.
Yeah, I'm playing this robot character, WX something or other, and I'm a complete newbie to this game, basically, so I don't really know what's going on too much. There's an axe here I'm going to pick up.
Yep, that's for you.
And I have watched a couple Let's Play of this game before, so I have a general idea of kind of what's going on.
Right. All right. So right now, we should focus on not starving. So these trees, which are new to the game, they came with the Reign of Giants DLC, I believe, drop birch nuts, these wavy trees here, like the trees from the Lorax. So they'll drop nuts so you can cook, and that will feed us until we can establish a base of operation.
Oh, so you can actually make a base?
Yeah, well, kind of. So eventually we'll need to build a science machine, which will allow us to research more stuff, like better equipment, armor, traps to trap rabbits and turkeys and birds and whatnot. And yeah, and then from there you can make an alchemy machine, which gives you even more stuff. But the problem is we need like a base of operations. And what I usually like in a base of operation is usually I pick a grassland with lots of rabbits, so we have like a never-ending food supply, so to speak.
Okay, now there was a little bit of a notice that popped up. It said, warning, night approaching.
Okay, so if you see, you probably know some of this. If you see that little clock dial, when it gets to like the bluish part, you don't want to be wandering around at night because that drains your sanity really, really low. And then you start having... And monsters come out. That's just a mole. let's see. I need to make another axe because your axe wears down quite quickly in this game. And pick up some grass.
Now, from what I can tell, I have enough resources to build a campfire now.
All right,
okay, so I should probably build a campfire soon, or...
Right now.
Should we stick together, though?
Yes. We should stick together. Where are you?
Okay.
Where
here,
are you?
Campfire? Okay, left trigger... Campfire...
No! This might be a short session! Okay.
Oh,
we're fine.
Okay.
Everything's okay.
Yeah.
you want to stay in the fire. I don't know what happened.
I'm going to add fuel to the fire.
Yep. And don't stand in the fire because
you might get burned.
Yeah. Like anything near the fire, see the smoldering grass? It will burn soon, right?
Woo!
Yeah. That's why you don't want to plant stuff near the fire because it will be consumed. Also, the nice thing is you can get ash from the fire, and if you get ash and spider glands, then you can make a healing salve.
Oh, can you?
How's your hunger meter? It's the little stomach icon.
I'm down about a third.
All right, so let me cook up some birch nuts for you. So
all you need to cook is
you just hover the thing to cook over the fire. And usually, it'll be fine. I think you could also eat these raw. But it's usually better to cook them, I feel. You'll get more nutrients. I guess there's some real-life mechanics to this.
Oh, is that for me?
Yep, go ahead. I got some stuff on my own, too.
Nummy.
I'm on fire. Why am I on fire?
No nummy,
fire.
Nummy, nummy.
All right.
Okay, so that's slowly filling up the hunger level.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so I have some grassland over here. So, to demonstrate how to catch a rabbit, let's find a rabbit hole.
Okay.
All right, here are some rabbit holes. So, what's this,
boulder.
So you can make a pick. So we need to find some flint to make a pick.
Gotcha.
So this is a rabbit trap. It's under your survival tab. So you just put it over. Well, technically they're not rabbits. They're jackalopes. I think.
And then you just
leave, and then hopefully there's a rabbit underneath the trap when you come back. The other thing you can do is you can bait the trap also. So if you put like a carrot, it'll have the option for you to bait it. So you could put it there, and then when you come back, there'll be a rabbit under there.
Okay. That's cool.
Yeah, because the birds and the rabbits run away from you if you try to chase them.
I noticed that. They're fast.
They're pretty fast. So I'm going to try to find some flint. So our first goal, if you look to the side, you will see the science tab that looks like a atom. And see on the faded out portion, there's a science machine. The science machine allows you to craft... to invent better things like armor and stuff like that. So that's what we're going to try to go for. The way we get gold is we have to use a pick to find rocks with a gold vein in them. And the ones that we found on the grassland don't have a gold vein, but they might provide flint or whatnot. So the first few days is always like this in Don't Starve. You just try to build up to the science machine.
Just grab what you can and try to feed your belly.
That's pretty much it. Oh, look, flint. All right. There's not that much flint around here in this world we spawned. That's odd. All right, so for
flowers. Flowers are good for what?
Flowers are good for... So you noticed on your meters, you also have a brain. That's your sanity meter. Flowers are... If you pick flowers, your sanity meter will go up.
Okay, is that something to do with the top hat on the left? It says garland. I could make something to soothe my nerves with enough flowers?
Yeah, you could do that too if you're really worried about... you could wear a flower crown. And if you're really worried about, you know, dropping low in sanity, like, for example, if you take a long walk in the dark by accident, and if you're not eaten by the monsters in the darkness, then the garland's pretty good early game to get your sanity back up to what it needs to be.
Okay. So now you constantly walk at the same speed, like there's no... sprint button or nothing?
There is no sprint button, and... Okay.
Okay, yep, but no... you move fairly quickly anyway, so...
You're gonna... How good are you at kiting?
You mean like luring a monster around?
Yes.
Well, it depends on the game.
I would say get good at kiting fast.
Okay, well, we should build another campfire.
Yeah. Oh, well, I wouldn't worry. You know, so I usually don't worry until I get, like, close to the dark part, because we're still okay, but it's nice to have the warning.
Okay, so when it's in red, that's sort of like dawn.
Yeah, it's pretty much like dusk.
Or dusk, I meant to say.
You can pick those up. So there's the gold we need to make the science machine. We can actually make the science... I actually have enough materials to make the science machine. Hold on, I gotta eat something. Like, in-game, I have to eat something. So,
sounds good. Do you need some food?
I got berries. I picked some. Ooh, graves. Huh. That's cool. So, once we build this... Well, we should find a nice... place to build a base of operations so we can go back and forth, and we don't have, you know, we wouldn't have to build a campfire each time, we wouldn't have to build a new science machine each time. That's why you want to have a base.
Okay, my little character, I'm looking at the gravestones, and what he was saying something. Meatlings are so superstitious.
we tend to be very superstitious.
But one of them, he says, "Hey, that's my name," on the
that
headstone.
Was probably a past robot. All right, let's make a
fire.
Yeah, you want? I got it.
Oh, okay.
All right. So these gravestones. Once we can we innovate a shovel right now? Oh, we could. Oh, you need to sign. Okay, so if you hover to your tools, you'll see that the shovel is faded and is locked. That's why we need the science machine, because certain things can only be unlocked by the science machine.
Okay, so the science machine gives you more things you can build.
Exactly.
I see.
That's why you need it first. Like, with the science machine, we can make a farm, meaning we can actually grow our own vegetables.
Okay.
Add fuel.
What's this thing I keep seeing running around the ground?
That's a mole. That's also was added in later on.
Do they attack you?
Only if you attack them.
Okay.
So I don't know if you want them to.
Well, I don't want it to attack me yet.
Not yet.
It's getting dark.
Yeah, you should stick around the fire. And usually this would be the time to innovate stuff if we had the science machine or we had a proper base of operations, but I don't think we have a good one yet.
Well, let's see. I can make an electrical doodad. No, I can't. I'm missing a brick or a rock or something.
So it's probably cut stone. That's also refined materials such as rope, cut stone, wooden planks. Also, those come from the science machine, I believe. It's been a while. I don't remember everything that you can make. We should also find some more food.
Nom, 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 nom.
Get away from those seeds, bird. I need those. All right, so
can you plant the seeds later? Grow a garden or something?
Yeah, so the farm will allow you to use the seeds you find to grow vegetables. So you don't have to go out into wilderness all the time and look for berries and carrots and all that other good stuff. You'll have a sustainable food source.
My axe broke. Okay, I'm going to build a new one.
Yeah, these go out pretty... These guys... go break pretty easily.
Okay, I can build an axe or a pickaxe.
A pickaxe will allow you to pick these rocks.
Right.
Which will allow you to make a fire pit when we finally have a base of operation.
Okay, I'm going to build a pickaxe, I think.
All right. I have plenty of logs, too, so it's cool. Oh, when you got time, come over here. I want to show you something.
Oh my god. What is that?
This is a wormhole. It will teleport you to another part of the map. However, it will drain some of your sanity. But since we have such high sanity at this point, we could jump in and see. I think I have enough food, so let's see.
It's a sarlacc.
It's pretty much a sarlacc pit. And now I am
Okay, you're short safe?
Yeah, I'm alive. Do you see somewhere that I am?
Okay,
dead?
I'm jumping in.
All right, I'm right here. Don't worry, buddy. Look, there's berries here and carrots.
Oh, berries!
And something that exploded, which I am hesitant about.
Food.
Oh boy, what exploded here? Oh, you could also be struck by lightning.
So the wormhole teleports you to a different map, or?
Different part of the map.
A different part of the map. Okay.
Right. Oh, look, bees. Please don't hit the bees.
Bees are bad.
Well, eventually you can harvest the hives for honey or the stingers to make long-range weapons. However, at such an early stage of the game, if you attack the beehive, if you really want to, I won't be near you when you do, these red bees will come out and attack you.
Mushroom is hiding.
Those mushrooms come out at night.
Oh.
There are certain things that come out at night. You could use a torch to walk around if you really want to, or you can eventually make a mining hat.
Okay, I'm going to have to eat something or other because my food level's getting about
half. I have
half.
A bunch of berries if you need some.
Well, I got some carrots and some berries, but they're not cooked. So.
That's fine. I mean, you could still eat uncooked food. It just won't be as... I don't know whether or not you just don't get as much health.
Not as yummy?
Not as yummy, pretty much. I made too many axes. If you need another axe, one's right here.
Yeah, I could use that.
All right.
Thank you. All right. Thank you.
So
thank you very much.
We should find a base. We should make a base somewhere. Like I said, if we can find one in grassland with a lot of rabbits, that would be great because it's a sustainable food source. I can't talk.
Well, preferably away from all these beehives.
Well, it might be useful if we can come back later and harvest honey, because honey is also, you can also make salves with honey, I believe.
Okay. So all there's right. A lot to this game.
Oh, this is excellent. So this is what we call a touchstone. So you just touch, I know it's a touchstone. I forget how to do things. So, I think later on in the game, you can respawn at the touchstone, but only once. So the game allows you to respawn. This is like, other than the meat effigy and the touchstones, I don't believe there is a way for you to come back if you die. I'm also not sure about, you know, co-op mode either. All I've seen from the Let's Plays on co-op mode is that you are a ghost. Like, when you die. I don't know how it works.
Okay, it's getting dark. I'm gonna build a fire.
Alright. I'm gonna chop a few more trees. We haven't found any good suitable places, and I'm getting a little worried. And the reason I'm getting a little worried is, so the game starts picking up at around day 10, I want to say. There'll be monsters that start coming after us. And you know, like, the monsters are getting close when you start hearing some snarling in the background. And that will happen probably a couple days, like maybe a week in or so. I don't know the timing of it. And they'll start they'll start trying to eat you. So we'll have to eventually make a spear and some armor to combat them. And that's why I said you might want to learn kiting, because the best way to defend against these animals is kiting them, actually, if you don't have good enough armor, which is actually easy to make because the first armor you can prototype from the science machine is wood armor, which wood is everywhere pretty much. Please ask me any questions if you have any.
Well, I think I'm going to plant some of these pine cones.
That's fine. There's no problem with that. Or you could use them as fuel, too.
And I'm assuming that that allows some trees to grow back, right?
They will regrow, yes.
Okay,
I'm
cool.
On fire again. Why do I keep on... I stand next to the fire. I am always on fire. Even when I play, like, World of Warcraft, I'm always on fire. Or in D&D, I'm always on fire.
Here's a tip. Don't stand in the fire.
That's usually what people tell me. How are you on food? I have some berries if you need some.
Thanks for reminding me. I'm getting low.
All right, I'm going to cook some of these berries and like...
I think I have... What do I have?
Here.
What is that?
Wait, no, you don't want the raw berries. Here, have the cooked berries.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
There you go.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much. I shall eat those berries. Yeah, my health was down to about a quarter level.
Yeah, there's a reason why this game's called Don't Starve.
Okay, right. So the cooked berries bumped it up pretty good.
Yep. They all cook stuff always do that.
sounds good to me.
And, so another trick people learn is, so say you have some raw carrots.
Yeah.
And you want to keep them longer. You can cook them and then they'll return to, I guess, optimum freshness, I guess. So if you notice in some of your inventory, some of the stuff is the background is green, signifying it's still good to eat. When it starts turning yellow, it's going to be orange, it's going to be stale, and red, it's pretty much not edible anymore. Or you shouldn't eat it, or you'll just feel terrible and, you know, I guess, do robots get tummy aches, apparently, I guess? Because you gotta eat, right?
Apparently.
Alright, I'm gonna pick up these things. Alright, so we should really try to find a nice grassland with some beefalo, which are like buffalo, but you can harvest them for meat eventually. So I'm starting to head south a little bit and picking up some grass along your way.
Sounds like a plan.
Yep. As you see, I have a magnificent beard going on. So eventually I can shave my own beard so we can use my beard shavings for the meat effigy we will eventually make. So when we die, we just respawn back at camp.
Bizarre.
It's weird. The only other way to get hair I found... Oh, this is perfect. Look, there. This is a beefalo. Please don't hit it.
No, I'm not going to hit it.
Also, the poop, the manure it drops, is a key ingredient in the farms that eventually we'll have to use for our farm. A key ingredient in the farms we'll eventually make. So okay. I think in my quote-unquote expert opinion, this would be a good spot because we got some beefalo, we got some rabbits, rabbit holes. I mean, I think this is a good candidate for a base, unless you prefer something else.
No, sounds good to me. Looks good to me.
All right, so I think I have enough to make a fire pit.
Okay.
So let's make this fire pit. It's made with rocks and wood. All right.
Okay, so how about the science machine now?
Right. Do you have any rocks on you? I used that for the fire pit because I'm a dummy.
I think I do. Hold on a second.
I need four, I think.
I have rocks. Okay, I will drop them.
That's flint.
Oh, that's flint. Okay.
All right. So we'll have to find rocks, which is...
Oh, no. I think I have them. One second.
Okay.
I will refine these into high technology, he says. Okay. Are these the rocks?
Yes. Perfect. So I will build the science machine.
Sounds good.
Behold, the power of science.
Ooh.
So if you stand next to it, you have all this stuff now that you can prototype.
Ah, I see.
Like rope.
Also, you have more tools available now.
Exactly. Planks are actually really good. Because if you drop two of them into the fire pit, that will keep the fire going on all night long. Like, you just need two planks. Because they're refined.
Shovel, now where would you use the shovel?
So those graves we saw earlier, you can dig the... I know it's terrible, and I know we're disturbing the dead. But literally, you can use them to make... you can dig up the graves. Sometimes they have gemstones. And the gemstones could be hold on to your butts. You can use the gemstones for magic. There is magic in this game.
Oh.
Like, you can make like a frost wand or a fire wand, and that would serve as your range weapon if you couldn't get a hold of, say, for example, bee stingers. Or teeth from something or another.
Well, you seem to know quite a bit about this game.
I have watched many Let's Plays while I've been painting miniatures, and yeah, okay. You need background noise, you know, when you work sometimes. Oh, fire's going out. I can put my planks in.
Like, I might have watched a Let's Play several months ago, so, but, I didn't know all the details that you do.
I had a lot of trial and error. I mean, I did play this game as a Let's Play. Are you hungry? Do you need food?
Oh yes, food would be good.
All right, here, have some carrots. They're cooked.
Nummy.
Seared to perfection.
Thank you.
But I did a Let's Play this earlier on my channel. No, I didn't want to eat. All right, no, fine. I ate them. I did a Let's Play on my channel earlier, and it was like me bumbling about like an idiot, you know, not surviving till day 6 or something like that, because I starved, obviously.
Ah.
Yes.
Well, speaking of eating, I think I might go have a late belated dinner.
Okay.
But, hey, we made it to
day 5.
The evening of day 4, almost day 5.
Yep.
And maybe we'll pick up this again soon for another session.
Sounds good.
So I'm going to leave a link to your channel in the video description. I would suggest go check out the very cute Game Master. She's awesome.
Yeah. And, you know, of course, check out Mixit Gaming. He's pretty awesome. And if you want to see more of our bumbling through the wilderness,
And that's what this was this time.
Yeah, this is bumbling through the wilderness. Sooner or later, maybe we'll be experts like it. Like you know, some people who've gone into day 101, for example. All right.
Okay. Well, thanks, and we'll say bye-bye for now.
Yep. See you later.